that we celebrate with joy the day of the Lord's resurrection. May be raised from the death of sin by your life-giving Spirit. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
Be seated for the reading.
Reading from the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wine, of rich food filled with marrow, of well-aged wine strained clear. And he will destroy on this mountain the shroud that is cast over the peoples, the sheet that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord will wipe away the tears from all faces, and the disgrace of his people he will take away from all the earth, for the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, lo, this is our God. We have waited for him so that he might save us. This is the Lord for whom we have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter began to speak to Cornelius and the other Gentiles. I truly understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee, after the baptism that John announced, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, how he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did, both in Judea and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. But God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear, not to all the people, but to us who were chosen by God as witnesses and who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus Christ, according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and he said to them, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." Then Peter and the other disciple set out and went toward the tomb. The two were running together, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in and saw the linen wrappings lying there, but he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came, following him, and went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there, and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head, not lying with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple, who reached the tomb first, also went in. He saw and believed, for as yet they did not understand the scripture, that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their homes. But Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head, and the other at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabuni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and say to them, 'I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God.'" Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord." She told them that he had said these things to her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Please be seated. In the name of the one holy and living God, amen.
Amen.
It's when she's weeping that he appears. John tells us that Mary Magdalene found the tomb empty and immediately ran off to tell the other disciples. Peter and the other disciple race to the tomb. Peter goes in first. The other disciple comes in next. They see the empty tomb. And John tells us that this is when they believe. Those disciples return to their home, but Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. And this is when it happens. What if sorrow and joy aren't opposites? What if sorrow and joy are in fact intertwined, knit together like an old scarf? What if in our sorrow, joy can take root? But Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look in the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." And then he is there. Jesus is there at her lowest point, and he sees her. And he calls her by name, and sorrow is transformed. This is my story, too. I was at the lowest point of my life about 15 years ago. I couldn't get sober no matter how hard I tried, no matter what I did. I lost nearly everything. Finally, I got the courage to go somewhere for help, again. I sat in the back of the meeting, sort of slouched down, afraid to be seen, afraid to be known. As soon as the meeting was over, I snuck out, trying to go quickly to my car, full of shame and regret. But I was stopped in the parking lot by this angry-looking bald man. And I was sure I had done something wrong, had breached etiquette in some way. But he looked at me, his grumpy eyes softened, and he said, "You never have to feel this way again. You never have to feel this way again." Jeffrey, that's his name, later shared with me his story, his sorrows, his regrets, and he listened to mine. And everything didn't just get immediately better, because that's not how life works. But in the sharing, in the listening, in the sitting together, resurrection broke through. Joy broke through. After realizing it was Jesus, Mary's sorrow is transformed. I don't believe it ever really went away, because that's not how sorrow works. It lives in us. Stays in us. After all, she's still trying to hold on to him. He has to tell her to let go. She does. And she becomes the apostle to the apostles, running to tell them, "I have seen the Lord." Sometimes we see the Lord at the empty tomb. Sometimes we see the Lord at church. I saw the Lord in the eyes of an angry-looking, recovering alcoholic in a parking lot in Dallas, Texas. Where have you seen the Lord? Mary's story is so compelling to me because it happens while she's weeping. It happens while she's lost
and confounded. She shares her loss with the disciples. She shares her grief with the angels. She shares her sorrow with the gardener who is not a gardener, and it becomes joy. I shared my story with Jeffrey and with others, and they shared their story with me, and together we experienced the sort of joy that has passed through the fire. Ross Gay says that joy is something like what we feel like when we help each other carry our sorrows. Joy is what we feel like when we help each other carry our sorrows. I would also call that practicing resurrection. This is what church can be, should be, is when we let it be. We bring our sorrows, we bring our griefs, we bring our frustrations, we bring them with us, yes, to the altar of God, but also to each other. We stand weeping outside the tombs of our life together until we see the Lord. Ross Gay imagines it like a dinner party, like a potluck. But instead of bringing deviled eggs, we bring our stories, our true selves, our sorrows. I bring my sorrows and you bring yours, and we see each other and we hear each other. And somewhere along the way, we find that in the sharing, in the hearing, in the bearing of one another's burdens, we are feeling something new, something that feels suspiciously like joy. And pretty soon we're laughing and talking and feeling not just a fleeting happiness, but a joy that knows sorrow and shares it and transforms it, and we know the joy of belonging. It's when she's weeping that he appears. It's when she's weeping that she sees the Lord. Christ is risen, friends, and rises again every time we stand beside those who are weeping. Every time we let people stand beside us when we are weeping, Christ is risen and is right here with us, calling us by name. Christ is risen, present in the sacrament on the altar and infusing all creation with resurrected joy. And Christ is risen, looking back at us through the people in this room. In this room, here with us. Christ is risen, turning sorrow to joy. So with Mary, let us say, I have seen the Lord. Amen. service, I invite anyone who is young and needs to be able to move so they can see, any kids that want to come up, or any short people at the back that want to come up. Yeah, Craig, 6'5". Yeah. To join us around the font. Through the Paschal mystery, dear friends, we are buried with Christ by baptism into his death and raised with him into newness of life. I call upon you, therefore, now that our Lenten fast is ended, to renew the solemn promises and vows of holy baptism, by which we once renounced Satan and all his works, and promised to serve God faithfully in God's holy Catholic Church. Do you reaffirm your renunciation of evil and renew your commitment to Jesus Christ?
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the Apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread, and in the prayers?
I will, with God's help.
Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord?
I will, with God's help.
Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ?
I will, with God's help.
Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself?
I will, with God's help.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being?
I will, with God's help.
May the Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us a new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed upon us the forgiveness of sins, keep us in eternal life by his grace, in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
Praise God who made heaven and earth.
Who keeps his promise forever.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Almighty God, whose Son, Jesus Christ, was baptized in the River Jordan, we thank you for the gift of water to cleanse us and revive us. Saving God.
Give us life.
We thank you that through the waters of the Red Sea, you led your people out of slavery to freedom in the Promised Land. Saving God.
Give us life.
We thank you that through the deep waters of death you brought your Son and raised him to life and triumph. Saving God.
Give us life.
Bless this water, that your servants who are washed in it may be made one with Christ in his death and in his resurrection, to be cleansed and delivered from all sin. Saving God.
Give us life.
Send your Holy Spirit upon us. Bring us to new birth in the household of faith and raise us with Christ to full and eternal life. For all might, majesty, authority, and power are yours now and forever.
Amen.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Alleluia.
the peace of Christ be always with you.
And also with you.
Please be seated. Happy Easter to everyone, and welcome to St. Anne's. When it comes time to receive communion today, please know that all are welcome to receive communion at St. Anne's. Simply come forward and stand or kneel at the altar rail. Hold out your hands to receive the bread, and then you can take one of the small cups of wine as they pass you by. If you would choose not to receive the wine, just cross your arms over your chest, and a server will pause in front of you and say the blood of Christ. All are welcome to come forward for communion. I heard a rumor that the Easter Bunny is on the way and will pay a visit. The Easter Bunny said they don't know if they're gonna come inside the church or in the yard, so we're gonna see where it is, if it's raining or not, when we're finished. So I invite all kids after church to gather in the parish hall, maybe grab a little quick snack, and then the Easter Bunny will let us know where they're gonna be so that we can have a little egg hunt together. Anyone can hunt eggs. It doesn't, you know. I do wanna take a moment to say this is about our seventh Holy Week service of the week, and so I wanna take just a moment to say thank you. I can't name everyone that does everything, it's impossible, but choir, altar guild servers, readers, lay leaders, hospitality leaders, it takes a lot of people to provide a platform, a space for our worship for the week, and I'm very grateful to you all. Yeah, very good. And then a reminder to everyone, since we don't know where the Easter Bunny's gonna be, please be careful as you're driving out of the parking lot today. There are lots of little bodies running around, so thank you. And now let us walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself an offering and sacrifice to God.
I know that my Redeemer lives. Glory, hallelujah.
offer you our sacrifice of praise. As we are fed with the bread of heaven, may we know your resurrection power. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
We praise you and we bless you, holy and gracious God, source of life abundant. From before time you made ready the creation. Your spirit moved over the deep and brought all things into being. Sun, moon, and stars, earth, wind, and waters, and every living thing. You made us in your image and taught us to walk in your ways. But we rebelled against you and wandered far away. And yet, as a mother cares for her children, you would not forget us. Time and again you called us to live in the fullness of your love. And so this day we join with saints and angels in the chorus of praise that rings through eternity, lifting our voices to magnify you as we sing.
She might conceive and bear a son, Jesus, the Holy Child of God. Living among us, Jesus loved us. He broke bread with outcasts and sinners, healed the sick, and proclaimed good news to the poor. He yearned to draw all the world to himself, yet we were heedless of his call to walk in love. Then the time came for him to complete upon the cross the sacrifice of his life and to be glorified by you. On the night before he died for us, Jesus was at table with his friends. He took bread, gave thanks to you, broke it, and gave it to them and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." As supper was ending, Jesus took the cup of wine. Again, he gave thanks to you, gave it to them, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Now gathered at your table, O God of all creation, and remembering Christ, crucified and risen, who was and is to come, we offer you our gifts of bread and wine and ourselves a living sacrifice. Pour out your spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the body and blood of Christ. Breathe your spirit over the whole earth and make us your new creation, the body of Christ given for the world you have made. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, to you be honor, glory, and praise forever and ever.
Amen.
And now as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done,
on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Alleluia. Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
The gifts of God, the people of God, take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your heart by faith.
Thank you.
pray. Loving God, we give you thanks for restoring us in your image
and nourishing us with spiritual food in the sacrament of Christ's body and blood. Now send us forth a people forgiven, healed, renewed, that we may proclaim your love to the world and continue in the risen life of Christ our Savior. Amen.
Now may Almighty God, who has redeemed us and made us his children through the resurrection of his Son, our Lord, bestow upon you the riches of his blessing.
Amen.
May God, who through the water of baptism has raised us from sin into newness of life, make you holy and worthy to be united with Christ forever.
Amen.
May God, who has brought us out of bondage to sin into true and lasting freedom in the Redeemer, bring you to your eternal inheritance.
Amen.
And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you and remain with you forever. Amen.
Amen.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.